Syria and Turkey started off searching together for the downed crew of the F-4 fighter jet Turkey says was on a training mission. But now it's been learned Syria shot unsuccessfully at a Turkish search plane, further inflaming tensions hours before a NATO meeting on the crisis. Turkey claims the plane that was shot down left one of its air bases and it briefly strayed into Syrian airspace. The Syrian, Turkey says, shot it down without warning. Turkey also says it went down in international waters. Syria says it used its anti-aircraft guns in self-defense.
And it has been a violation of Syrian sovereignty.
The U.S. isn't buying it.
It was just shot out of the sky, and that obviously is not in keeping with international norms in such incidents.
NATO isn't likely to authorize military action even now.
So NATO has not brought itself together to get involved in Syria yet. It's just too messy.
But if the U.S. military had to get involved, jets could quickly begin flying combat missions out of southern Europe. There are also U.S. warships off Israel's Mediterranean coast. Their regular job, using advanced radars and missiles to defend Israel from a potential air attack by Iran. They could be moved north in a matter of hours. The Syrian regime is expected to maintain power, but the Obama administration believes there are growing cracks in Bashar al-Assad's iron grip.
But there were dozens of Syrian military who defected to Turkey overnight with their families, that there are at least 38 soldiers, including military officers. So this appears to be an increasing pace of these kinds of military folks voting with their feet.
Now, Turkey, of course, is a member of the NATO alliance, so an attack against Turkey is an attack against NATO under the rules, but still don't expect to see NATO commit military force to the Syrian crisis. Joe?
Thanks so much for that, Barbara Starr at the Pentagon.